Hi everyone, my name is Julie, and today we're traveling to the land of the rising sun. But we're not going to talk about Japanese. There exists another language that has been spoken here for thousands of years. Iran karapte, and welcome to the Ainu language. Ainu is a unique language, literally. There is no other language that even closely resembles to it. Good news, it's still alive, but bad news, it might not be for long. Ainus live mainly on the Hokkaido and Honshu islands of Japan. There are around 25,000 people who identify themselves as Ainus. The sad part is that there are officially only two remaining native speakers, but there might be more. Some people might not be officially admitting it. Plus, there are more people who either have a limited knowledge of Ainu or who study it as a second language, but the number of those is unknown. So, what makes this language so unique? Apart from its rarity, obviously. And by the way, if you want to learn more about rare and unique languages, then definitely subscribe to this channel and don't forget that like button. There's loads of uniqueness in Ainu, so let's start discussing it with some history. Studying Ainu history is extremely difficult because nothing is really known about it. It is accepted that Ainus are the indigenous people of Japan and that they or their ancestors were the Jalman people who arrived to Japan around 14,000 BC. In turn, nobody knows who these people were and where they came from. Ainus are very distinct people linguistically, genetically, and anthropologically. Their appearance is strikingly different from the populations that surround them, and from anybody else on the planet for that matters. It is even considered that Ainus, being isolated on the Japanese islands for that long, have developed into a separate race. Linguistic analysis doesn't help to connect the dots. Ainu language isn't isolate, as it doesn't have any proved relatives. There has been countless pieces of research trying, unsuccessfully, to link Ainu to anything you could possibly ever imagine. It has been grouped in Paleo-Siberian languages, but this group represents a collection of languages or language families in East Asia that no one really knows what to link with. Obviously, there has been attempts to link Ainu to Japanese or Korean, only to conclude that Ainu is not related to any of them. There are hypotheses that try to link Ainu to Basque, and it seems like these days everyone is trying to link anything to Basque, but they all fail. There also has been attempts to connect Ainu to Native American, Austroasiatic, or Austronesian languages, but with no convincing results so far. Interesting research has been done in the field of genetics. There is a rare haplogroup D, which is only found in a small quantity in Tibet, a lot of it on the Andaman Islands, and surprise surprise, in Japan, especially among Ainus. Andamanese, another isolated and unique people group. Could it be possible that there is a linguistic connection between them and Ainus? Surprisingly, there actually has been a research claiming that indeed the Great Andamanese languages and Ainu language are related. I'll put a link in the description so you can check it out. So we could imagine, just imagine, that Ainus could have been part of the people groups that first left Africa and ventured to new lands following the coastline. Some of them settled on the Andaman Islands and remained there. Others continued north and arrived to Japan, which back then had a land bridge. Then sea levels rose, those people became cut off from the mainland, their skin became light as an adaptation to their environment. Of course, none of this is proved, and we're in the land of hypotheses and theories here, but what if it did actually happen that way? The Jalman people were leading their hunter-gatherer lifestyle for thousands of years when the Yayoi, or the ancestors of modern Japanese, arrived from the Korean peninsula in the first millennia BC. They were rice cultivars, so they easily outnumbered the Jalman, pushing them to the northern island of Hokkaido. Ainus then also migrated to Kuril Islands, Sakhalin, and Kamchatka. They remained hunter-gatherers for almost the entirety of their history. Men, after a certain age, never shaved beards. Women tattooed their mouth and forearms, which led some researchers believe that Ainus originally came from the south, as tattooing, as well as using poisoned arrows that they also did, was a custom more commonly found in equatorial people. Which, by the way, goes in line with that Andamanese theory we discussed before. Similarly to other people of Siberia, though, they worshipped the bear, who was the head of all the deities and spirits. These are called Камуй, and they inhabit virtually everything. This concept actually is almost synonymous with Japanese kami, and even the name sounds almost completely the same, and it is unclear who adopted it from who and if it is even related, because, of course, it could all have been just a coincidence. Yukar are the traditional Ainu oral sagas that are transmitted from generation to generation. One of them actually mentions that the Ainu lived in this place 100,000 years before the children of the sun came, which confirms that Ainus were living on these islands long before the Japanese. The government of the children of the sun decided by the end of the 19th century to forcefully assimilate Ainus into the Japanese society. Already outnumbered, Ainu population started shrinking swiftly, and even to this day, many Ainus will hide their ancestry or their knowledge of Ainu language, fearing discrimination. After World War II, Ainus living on the territory of the USSR were sent to Japan, the remaining intermixed with other people groups. The status of Ainu language has been changing recently. In 1997, Ainus were given indigenous rights in Japan, and interest in their culture has been on the rise since. There are revitalization efforts to help preserve the language, as for example textbooks and classes, but for now it is more than unsure if Ainu language will be able to survive. And if it doesn't, it will be an enormous loss for the linguistic history of the whole world. So let us learn more about this rare and important language, starting with pronunciation. Ainu never had its own writing system, even though there are researchers that speculate that the Jomon people might have had one. Nowadays, Ainu is mostly written in the katakana, a Japanese syllabary, which is not surprising as virtually all Ainus live in Japan. However, katakana might not be the best writing system for Ainu, as it is a syllabary which is just right for Japanese, as it only has open syllables, but Ainu can have any type of syllable. So to write a closed syllable, like in word itak, for example, the small katakana symbol for ku is used. Moreover, for r sound, any of the five katakanas involving the sound r can be used depending on the sound that goes before it. So in the word chikir, the sound I goes before the sound r, so the katakana ri is used. This type of writing seems to unnecessarily overcomplicate Ainu, as it is actually much more convenient to transcribe Ainu in an alphabetical system. So in the Latin version of the alphabet, Ainu has 16 letters. Obviously, in katakana there are many more, as all the 46 symbols can be used. The pronunciation of all sounds is pretty obvious, except maybe that this letter is pronounced as ch, and the u under the influence of Japanese sounds more often like u. And in general, as the language nowadays is mostly spoken by Ainus that have Japanese as their native language, the influence of Japanese pronunciation is huge, and it's very difficult to find a speaker who would pronounce Ainu without a Japanese accent. So let's hear now how Ainu sounds today.
Itako cha wa karape mako oripaki wa okaru ene Littun na Aere apukoro pai anai ne Littun na Kotan pa humara kotan kesi humara inne kotan ari korachi anru ene Littun na Kotan koro nishpa tumakoro ki wa Littun na.
Even despite the Japanese accent, it is still clear that Ainu is very different from its big neighbor. Now let's see if its grammar is any different. Ainu doesn't have gender, cases, tenses, which makes the job of any Ainu language learner much easier and pleasant. There are some particularities though, so let's explore that. It's an SOV language, and like in English, the word order conveys the meaning. There are no particles to indicate subject or object, but there are particles to indicate pretty much anything else. A topic, a location, a question, or an intonation. The subject cannot be dropped, but instead of pronouns, prefixes or suffixes are used, which are attached to a verb. These are also used to indicate possession. Verbs could also be modified depending on the number. More than modified, actually. Some verbs are completely different in their singular and plural forms. There are also no adjectives. Instead, these are expressed by verbs. For example, poro, to be large, pon, to be small, and pirka, to be good. And now let's see what other interesting things we can find in Ainu, particularly in Ainu vocabulary. Of course, being completely integrated in the Japanese culture means that there is an enormous number of Japanese loanwords in Ainu. Most of these cover words that were not part of traditional Ainu lifestyle, like money, ichen, which comes from ichien, 1 yen, or keitai denwa, mobile phone. And when adopting such new concepts, these are sometimes not even written in katakana in Ainu, but in kanji, exactly like in Japanese. Ainu influence is present in Japanese too, particularly in place names, especially in Hokkaido, where even the capital Sapporo comes from the Ainu Sapporo, dry place. It's easy to recognize Ainu-originated place names. Those may end in Betsu, which comes from Pet, river, Nai, which comes from Nai, creek, and Hira, which comes from Pira, cliff. Some even speculate that even the Mount Fuji's name originated from the Ainu fireplace goddess's name, Kamui Huchi. By studying Ainu, we could discover pages of early human evolution history that are for now unknown to us. That is why it is crucial to preserve this language. Please write in the comments, what did you think about Ainu? Special thanks to my patrons, especially for my top tier who voted on this language. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.